as we walk through the sacrament of holy baptism, for those of you who are visiting with us today, bear in mind that this is a church family event mainly, so you don't have to feel obligated to feel like you need to follow along with the words that are for the congregation as we renew our vows and things like that. But as we are standing together, especially as witnesses to this wonderful event, the responses for the congregation and the members of the church will be on the screen in front of you. And also there is a place when we are going through this where we'll, in question and answer form, say the what we believe through the Apostles' Creed. And I invite everyone to participate in that, and all of that will be on the monitor for you as well. Brothers and sisters in Christ, through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated into Christ's holy church. We are incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given new birth through water and the Spirit. All this is God's gift offered to us with Christ. I present Hannah Elizabeth Webster for holy baptism this day. To the parents and the sponsors, I ask on behalf of the whole church, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, sin? Do you?
We do.
Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? Do you?
We do.
Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in His grace, and promise to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races? Do you? Nurture Hannah in Christ's holy church, that by your teaching and example that she may be guided to accept God's grace for herself, to profess her faith openly, and to lead a Christian life. Will you? And now, for the body of Christ, do you, as Christ's body, the church, this is where your part is on the screen, do you, as Christ's body, the church, reaffirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ? Do you?
Yeah.
Will you nurture one another in the Christian faith and life, and include Hannah, who is now before you, in your care?
God's help, we will proclaim the good news of the Lord Jesus Christ. We will surround her with the community of love and forgiveness, that she may grow in her trust in God and be found faithful in her service to others. We will pray for her.
And I invite us all now to join together in professing the Christian faith as contained in the scriptures of the Old and New Testament. These are the words in the bold print from the Apostles' Creed. Do you believe in God the Father? I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ? I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day He rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. This next section is our prayer of thanksgiving over the water, and all the bold print that you'll see on the screen is for the entire congregation. Let's begin with the greeting. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Eternal Father, when nothing existed but chaos, you swept across the dark waters and brought forth life. In the days of Noah, you saved those on the ark through water. After the flood, you set in the clouds a rainbow. When you saw your people as slaves in Egypt, you led them to freedom through the seal. Their children you brought through the Jordan to the land which you promised. In the fullness of time, you sent Jesus, nurtured in the water of the womb. He was baptized by John and anointed by by your Spirit. He called his disciples to share in the baptism of his death and resurrection and to make disciples of all nations. Declare Christ's works to the nations, his glory among all the people. Pour out your Holy Spirit to bless this gift of water and those who receive it, to wash away her sin and to clothe her in righteousness throughout her life, that dying and being raised with Christ, she may share in his final victory. All praise to you, eternal Father, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns forever. Amen. Thank you all.